Welcome to Wembley Stadium, the scene of the 1967 League Cup final between 3rd Division Queen's Park Rangers and the holders 1st Division West Bromwich Albion. Now the two teams will be appearing, and I think they're coming. Yes, here they come. And there's Alex Scott, who today completes 21 years as a football club manager. And if you thought that was Ron Springer, the Rangers goalkeeper, Rangers on the right, it isn't, it's his brother Peter. And banners, flags. Goodness, there's what? Breakout all over Wembley and the Queen's Park Rangers chant of Rodney, Rodney, Rodney for Rodney Marsh. There's the Queen's Park Rangers team. Don't worry about those colours, they're still wearing the tracksuit tops, and that is the side. And the front four, the great goal-scoring combination from the 3rd Division, and number 10, Rodney Marsh, the idol of all the Queen's Park Rangers fans. And there's Rodney Marsh, the man they will be chanting to, Rodney, 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 all afternoon. West Bromwich Albion, still wearing tracksuit tops, and they had a shot just before the kickoff. Jones, their number 5, found unfit, so Dennis Clark will play at number 5. Number 11, a former Queen's Park Rangers player, Clive Clark. No relation, a different spelling, you'll see, from Dennis Clark, who's playing number 5. And there's the two captains. Mike Keane on the left, playing his 214th consecutive game for the Rangers. He hasn't missed a game for 4 years, League Cup or friendly. The players strip off. We see that Rangers are wearing all white, and for those who like to make a note of the colours, the Albion are wearing all red. There's number 11, Clive Clark, playing against his former club. He scored in every game, every round, every leg of this Football League Cup competition. John Kay, one of the best attack leaders in the business. And Jeff Astle alongside him. What a dangerous combination these two are. Coming over to the right, it was Tony Brown, who scored in every round last season. And so Wembley is all set for the kickoff of this first ever League Cup final on this famous stadium. The sun is shining, as you can see from the shadows. The ground is packed. The Rangers from the 3rd Division kick off. Mr. Crossley of Lancaster checking his watches, and away we go. And when you hear the beating of drums, don't worry, it's just the Rangers supporters. This will be an all-out attacking game. Two teams are not counter-attackers, they're all out attacking teams. Rangers throw. Think there'll be any special marking in this match, because these two teams just want to move forward on the attack, not to spend their time trying to nullify the opposition. One thing we've noticed is that Kay has been beaten there by Keane. He's playing midfield for the Albion. Yes, Peter Springett, the brother of Ron Springett of Sheffield Wednesday and England. Dennis Clark straight into the game. Sanderson, the schemer of the Rangers. Free kick to Rangers. Fouled by Brown. Free kick going to be taken by 38-year-old Jim Langley, the daddy of them all this afternoon. Graham with the throw. Collard across to Fraser. On top, and here's Allen for the Rangers. He's all on his own. There's Allen, number nine, still a very dangerous man, especially near goal, and a vast experience, former Chelsea and Tottenham player. Langley, number two. Oh, Langley, what a mistake. Notice how he was quick to recover from it. The work by Collard. Jim Langley, not the sort of player to be upset by one early error. That's where all the noise is coming from. Cramp. Cramp to Hope. Up now comes Fraser. This is good football. And it comes with Old Clark has scored! Clark has scored against his old team. 7 minutes gone. Clive Clark has done it against his old team. So has kept up his record of scoring in every game in the competition. So, the Rangers are 1-0 down after 7 minutes. Could well have the highest scoring cup final ever at Wembley, and he still could. Oh, lovely football by the Albion. Cram now to Kay. It's Cram again, number two. Number nine is Kay. Keane for the Rangers. Keane now to Morgan. Allen has moved on to the wing, but no one's taken his place in the middle. Langley, a good ball to Sibley. Allen coming in from the wing, a beautiful one. Great save by Rick Shepherd and a great shot by number nine, Les Allen. Brown out to Clark. Play on. Quite right, this is the referee. Sanderson now to Allen. Fraser to Clark. And Hazel does bring Clark down. Free kick to the Albion. They're playing some great stuff now. 10 minutes gone. free kick to Albion, who lead 1-0 and hope to take this free kick. Dangerous position this. Now Langley to Sanderson. Rangers left to play it onto the wings. Okay, working in midfield. Now Morgan, number 11 for Rangers. Young Roger Morgan. Came to the youth side of the Rangers. Not a seat, not a bit of standing space to be had at Wembley. Here's Langley. Oh, what a beautiful ball, but gorgeously cut off by Williams. Lazarus. I've been packing well in the penalty area. Play on. There's Cram. Cram to Brown. Number two is Cram. Not to get anything, Rangers a wee bit too obvious in there ever to get the ball to Lazarus. Williams with a throw for Albion. Gorgeous sunny day. There's young Peter Springett. Okay. Sibley, oh, that's a good ball. Sibley through to Keane. And Dennis Clark showing no signs of nerve. Number five for Albion. Morgan, the flags up for offside. And that's a typical Rodney Marsh move, but it doesn't count. The old quarter phase of football had to bring something out even though he was offside. Sanderson to Hazel. Now it's not out of play. Play on. Lazarus to Keane. Chance for Albion to stick away. It's Clark. He's got Astor with him. It's two against two. And now it's two against one. Astor. Oh, what a great save. A corner. It's a corner. Hard luck on Springett then when Sibley put it behind, but what a great save by Springett from Astor. There's Astor. A great move between him and Clark. Corner to Albion. Oh, those have come from the Rangers supporters, those toilet rolls, streamers and what have you. Hope at the corner. And who's gone down? It's Astor. Astor hurt. Jeff Astle all right again. Jim Langley, the white shirt, just saying that he's quite all right. And it's a goal kick to the Rangers. Notice the natty jockey cap being worn by Peter Springard, whose brother Ron was in the FA Cup final here last May. Morgan, number 11. To Keane. Rangers desperately need a goal to restore their confidence. Bit of offside there against Brown. It came back after the ball was played, but he was offside when the ball was played. Notice how Brown, number 7, and Clark, number 11, keep coming into the middle for Albion. Hunt with a free kick for the Rangers. Allen. Morgan. Allen. Here comes Lazarus. That's Williams for the Albion, up to Astle. Clark. Brown. Out of Kay. Hope. Bobby Hope. A fine player. Surely will get a Scottish cap soon if he keeps on playing as well as he is doing this season. Sanderson. To Lazarus. Allen. Just Hope and challenging in defence and winning the 2-4-6. Albion players back in defence now covering their goalkeeper. Kay coming back to make it 7. Shows you how fluid Albion are. Lazarus to Allen. Lazarus. Rangers being hopelessly outnumbered when they come onto the attack. As Kay bringing it clear for Albion. Through to Astle, what a glorious pass! Fine move by Albion. There's Allen. To Morgan. Sanderson. Almost worked that pass inside the back by Sanderson. Hazel. Sanderson once again now to Morgan. 10 minutes from half time. And the linesman is flagging. I think he's giving the free kick to, well, I think the linesman flagged it as a free kick for the Raiders, but the referee didn't get the first offence. You can call it an offence, and he's given the kick to the Albion. Linesman definitely flagged and pointed the other way. So it's Hope to take the free kick. Fraser's Rangers come out to try and play somebody offside. And they fail, and there's Brown with a chance. Got Clark with him, and Clark is onside, and Clark's made it through. And Clark has got the second. 36 minutes gone. The Rangers fans feel, A, the free kick should have been the other way. And so, the Albion lead. They also feel that Clark was offside. It doesn't matter what they feel, it's what the referee says. I hope. Lovely ball to Brown. little bit of covering by number six, Sibley. Incidentally, Queen's Park Rangers have only lost two games all season. They're up against it now. Fraser. Hope. Rose given to Rangers. And number 11, Morgan, takes it. No, a free kick. A foul on them. On Marsh, free kick to the Rangers. Marsh to Sanderson. That's not broke out for Marsh. Not sparkling on this Wembley turf as he normally does. He's been a very disappointed man so far. And the whistle goes for half-time. Scorer of both goals, Clive Clark. Number 11 for Albion. There he is. The former Queen's Park Rangers player has in fact crushed their hopes of winning the Football League Cup. We just had a word from Alex Stock that he was not satisfied in the first half. He's going to give his strong talking to his forwards. Well, they've had it, and let's see what difference it's going to make. As West Brom kick off. Remember, they're 2-0 in the lead. Clark having scored both goals. There's Clive Clark. The pressure off Albion now, but remember that in the FA Cup final last season, the team was two goals up and lost. So they still have a chance, and the linesman's flag is up. Free kick to Queen's Park Rangers. No disgrace in the way the Rangers are playing this afternoon, but let's remember, they're used to third division opposition, and this afternoon they're up against a very good first division side. Allen. Was there. Albion have got quite a record to maintain. That wasn't a foul. Albion's record is that no one has ever won the cup twice before, and only once has the cup ever been out of the Midlands, so almost the Midlands' home property. That's Morgan for the Rangers. That's a bad ball. Williams, Graham Williams, the Albion captain. Allen to take the free kick for the Rangers. 11 Albion men back in their own defence. And it's a goal! Scored by Morgan! Morgan, number 11, has made it 2-1. And my goodness, the Rangers fans have gone wild. All right, your hair's straight enough. Never mind your hair, son. You've got one. Now then, what a final this is going to be. And we've got 25 minutes left, free kick to Albion. Hands by Marsh. Somebody will be getting an early bar. So with every Albion player back in defence now, it's Langley with the free kick for Rangers. And about 50,000 Rangers fans willing another goal. It's going to be a good one to beat this goalkeeper, Shepherd. Clark. Hope and Clark's move down the left wing, but it's bad ball. Fraser. And that's a good one to Brown. Now to Clark. Albion have got to come out now. They're going to do something about it. And look at Clark doing it. And Langley. To Morgan, the goal scorer. Throw to Albion. 20 minutes of the second half gone. West Bromwich Albion leading 2-1. Collard to number 6, Fraser. Now Hope. That's a little play, this boy. I was hoping. Hope, number 10, was hoping someone was cutting in from the right. Sibley, to Allen, to Marsh. To Morgan. Was up the offside anyway. There's Roger Morgan, the boy who put heart into Queen's Park Rangers supporters by getting that goal. Pick up Langley. Now, Hope. Williams, I think it rebounded and hit him full in the face. But the game goes on as Allen is chopped down by Fraser. Free kick to Rangers, and the game goes on as Williams is out of the match. And he's on his feet now, but he must be feeling a bit woozy. Now Brown to Clark. And Williams has gone down on his knees again. There's Williams. Graham Williams, he must have got a terrible bang. Must feel like a boxer who's been knocked down by a good punch and got up at two. The wild drums of Shepherd's Bush.
Both goals.
Now see how Williams reacts after his bang on his head. Well kept in by Williams. A foul by Lazarus on Williams. Handily enough, the Albion trainer was right there. Might have wanted to go over the touchline for treatment. And Lazarus is laughing at the booing Albion supporters. That's a typical Queen's Park Rangers gesture. That is such a homely club, the players, or rather the crowd, are so near the playing pitch there, they often have conversations with the fans. Collard with the free kick. Tomas to Keane. Keane can have another goal. Marsh to Sanderson. Up on the right comes Lazarus. And flags up an offside, yes. Lazarus, number 7, just holding it a wee bit too long. The Albion defence, time to come out and get a couple of men offside. Certainly this has been a stirring struggle. And it's a long way from being over yet. And again, Austin's got kicked in the face with Jim Langley. The last man I should think to kick anybody realises immediately. One of those things. One of those strange things about football, a free kick's got to be given, and yet there's not a soul in football would believe that Jim Langley would ever intentionally kick a man. That's the second time Astor's had it in the face. So up we go again, and there's the score. Number 11s have got all the goals. Clark 2 for Albion, Morgan for Rangers. And Cram with the free kick. And of course, by Astle on Hazel. Jeff Astle. He just playing the ball in the air, and when it's on the ground. Referee going to have a word with Kay for holding the ball like that. No, got the free kick over. Dean to number 10, nice. Oh, he's a goal! Marsh has scored! Oh, what a goal! Celtic supporters gone on the field to have a word with Astle. Oh, what a goal by Rodney Marsh. And it's Queen's Park Rangers in the second half again. And for the first time ever, a supporter's gone on the field and nobody has touched him as yet. Once again, Queen's Park Rangers have done it in the second half. And here comes Keane. Allen. And it was Allen. And to set the seal on this happy and great occasion, even the spectator who ran on the pitch to congratulate everyone who's been allowed to go back to his place. And here comes Albion, it's Brown. Tony Brown. And it didn't miss scoring in a tie last season. Well, about a quarter of an hour left and it's 2-2. A sensational comeback by third division Rangers. Here goes Kay. To Kay. Up comes Fraser. Astle. Steve Astle. I'd have him my side any time. And we want three from the Rangers fans. There's just no stopping them. We won three, but all they've got is a free kick at the moment. Allen, two, Morgan. Certainly the first League Cup final at Wembley has been a 100% success. Capacity crowd and what a game. Astle back to Williams. Allen. A change in tactics of the Rangers. Allen's begun to go deep now, leave Marsh upfield. At almost an anonymous first half, suddenly sprung into his own. Fraser. Keane. And Kay coming back for the Albion. Cramp to number six, Fraser. A bit then. Marsh to Sanderson and up comes Keane. Marsh stays down. Then Chickley gets up with the ball, comes to him. Oh, beautiful one from Marsh to Morgan. Ball. What a beautiful pass though that was from Marsh out to Morgan. Completely changed the direction of the attack and had the Albion flummoxed. Back to Astle for the Albion. Up number 11 is Clark. Oh, good bit of running by Hope to Clark some of the pass too. This is Cran. Edmunds Astle. Well, even if the Rangers get beaten now, they still carve for themselves a niche in footballing history. That's a goal. 10 minutes left, and there's extra time. And I think those fans would love extra time because this has been a stirring struggle. Allen with the corner for the Rangers. Albion have got 8 men in the penalty area. Williams the saviour then. It comes to. Oh, Allen telegraphed that and he was obstructed. Made in front of the linesman. It's not been altogether popular, that gentleman, with the Rangers fans. Then linesmen never are popular, are they? Allen with the free kick. More Albion players packed back in goal. It's Hunt. Lazarus and Hunt. Lazarus, it's a goal. Rangers are in the lead. And Springett comes out of his goal to join in the celebration. Joining in the celebration. What a sensational side at Wembley. And Shepherd is injured. And that is 2 weeks in succession we've seen a goal scored in match of the day with the goalkeeper lying injured. Still not satisfied, those Rangers fans. They want more now. There's Mark Lazarus going over to the fans. Every one of these Queen's Park Rangers players is a matador at heart. Have you ever seen anything like that at Wembley? Going over to shake hands with them now. And poor old Rick Shepherd still doesn't know anything about it. No doubt about it, it was a goal. He went down, an accidental collision, and it ran loose to this man, the goal scorer. Mark Lazarus. Wembley Stadium has never had a moment like this. With a third division team playing in a cup final here for the very first time. 2 down, now lead 3-2. And this is the second cup final in succession. But a team 2 down has come back to take the lead 3-2. Last year, the goalkeeper, Jimmy Wednesday, was one Springett. This side was 2 up. Then 3-2 down. This time, his young brother Peter is in the opposite situation. Shepherd all right again. The Rangers fans preparing to tear Wembley Stadium apart and then start on Shepherd Bush. I only hope the BBC Television Centre can escape the celebration. Now here's Allen. And away goes Morgan. Time to head on in this match. This half, rather. Six minutes by our watch, but it's 6 minutes plus injury time. Now here's Fraser number 6. Jim Langley. Twice he was in the beaten side in an FA Cup semi-final. Now it looks as if he's going to get a League Cup medal. Well, there's not a Rangers player upfield now. Uncharacteristic of them, though, to concentrate on defence. Hope. Okay. 3 minutes left. That's counting injuries now. Alan. Fraser to Astor. But now a chance for Lazarus to break clear. Morgan, you're offside. Morgan's offside, so Lazarus was doing himself. He has both. Mark Lazarus, what a player this. He's been regarded as a cast-off about 3 times in his career, and he's still only about 26 or 27. They'll talk about this game for years and years and years. And it's over! The third division club have won, and with Bromwich Albion now defeated for the first time, there's Mark Lazarus who got the winning goal. Football ever known anything like this? A third division team has reached a cup final at Wembley for the first time, and not only won but come back from 2 down to win 3-2. And there's Jim Langley, number 3, at 38, has got a cup winner's medal. The scoreline we never expected to see, and up goes Mike Keane, his 214th consecutive appearance for Queen's Park Rangers, goes up to receive the cup from the Lord Mayor of London, Sir Robert Bellinger. This, a memorable, unforgettable occasion. 100,000 people have seen little Queen's Park Rangers come back from 2 down to win 3-2. And there is Mike Keane. Lord Mayor of London, himself a director of Arsenal, must realise what a fantastic feat this is. And all I can say to anybody is keep clear of Shepherd's Bush tonight. And there's Morgan, who got the first goal. Well, you can fill it tonight, sir. Who got the winning goal, and now the Albion, who must have thought that for the second year in succession they had won the League Cup. And there's Jim Gaunt, the Albion chairman, next to Lord Harwood. Jim Gaunt just recovered from a serious operation, must have thought that the League Cup was his. And a supporter has got onto the field, one of the men who carried the coffin of the Albion, and he's joining. There he is. Well, they'll be dancing all night. Well, Shepherd's Bush Green with those drums, I should think. And now they approach the drum of Shepherd's Bush. What a great moment, too, for Alex Stock, who today completes 21 years as a football club manager and sees his third division team, Queen's Park Rangers, get a standing ovation at Wembley, having won the Football League Cup 3-2 to First Division West Bromwich Albion, and having been 2-0 down into the bargain.